Speaker, that will be Katalin, and he will be talking about cohesion network analysis predicting user ranks in Reddit communities.
All right,
you have the floor.
Thank you for giving me the floor. So I will share now the presentation. Just a moment. Okay. Can you see now?
Yes.
All right, perfect. Good, so my name is Cătălin Fătoiu and I will present you our research paper that is called, that is about predicting user ranks in Reddit communities in the context of cohesion network analysis. This paper was done as part of the Reader Bench Research Laboratory in, at University Polytehnica of Bucharest. And I want to begin by firstly thanking all of the people that were implicated in the project, as they are written here under the title. So I want to begin with that and for making this this possible. Okay, and moving forward. Let's begin by establishing some of the core concepts that were related to our paper. The first one is Reddit. So as many of you probably know, Reddit is a big social media website that has more than 138,000 communities and more than 330 million users. And it is structured as a huge collection of individual communities, which are commonly called subreddits. So one example is the Ask Reddit subreddit, which is the main community for asking any type of question. So on Reddit, usually people can share news, articles, images, ideas, debate, all sorts of ideas, or simple, or as for example, learn new skills. So it is a very diverse set of communities. Each one is structured in a set of discussion threads, each one with multiple comments. Each comment can receive upvotes and downvotes based on the user that, on the user preferences of the ones that read it. Importantly, based on those votes, each user will have a so-called social rank, which is commonly called on Reddit karma, which is an aggregation of all of these votes. This is the thing that we wanted to predict. It is important to mention before moving forward that the formula that Reddit uses for computing this karma score is not public, so we generated our own custom formula, which is based on counting all the up votes and subtracting half of the down votes from them. So basically, we give a bigger importance to the up votes. Okay, the next topic is cohesion network analysis. So let's define this term as it is implemented in the Reader Bench framework. So the main aspect of this model is cohesion, which is a synonym for coherence. And one general definition for this would be an aggregation of various semantic distances between elements of the conversation. A more simple definition would be how relevant is the relation between two particular comments or two particular elements of the conversation. So for example, if I reply to somebody else's comments, this cohesion would measure how relevant was my response compared to the original comment. Another important aspect of cohesion network analysis is the cohesion graph, which is created from all the components of the conversation. So starting from the whole community to individual discussion threads and to individual comments. And computing the cohesion scores between each pair of those. And based on this cohesion graph, we compute the what we call CNA indices, which are aggregations of these cohesion scores between for each user. So, for example, one of the most important indices are in degree and out degree, and we can see those as, for example, in degree, the sum of all the cohesion scores for all the between the all the comments of the user in relation to their parent comment. Okay, and moving forward, another topic is regularity analysis, which measures the activity of a user in the community, and it unveils his or her patterns of interaction with the community. It is simply based on the set of all the timestamps of all the users' comments, which are sorted. And based on those, basically we can, for every time interval, we can verify if the user made a comment in that specific interval. And based on this, we computed two main categories of indices. The first one is called PDH and PWD, which check if the user comments are concentrated around a particular hour in the day or a particular day in the week. And the second category, WS1, 2, or 3, computes various similarities between the user activity in every pair of weeks in the whole time frame analyzed. Our main research question is, as you can see, to what extent do these CNA indices, also textual complexity, I forgot to mention them, they are also a category of indices computed in ReaderBench, which focus individually on the text of a user. So they can be related to its writing style or how many topics uses or stuff like that. So to what extent do CNA, textual complexity, and regularity indices predict the user rank on Reddit? So our aim was to generate those indices, also create using the ReaderBench framework some interactive visualizations of the community, and using various machine learning models to predict the user ranked using the previous mentioned features or indices. And now moving forward to the method, we will talk a bit about the corpus of data that we used for our experiments, and also about the whole pipeline that we built, which starts from data crawling and up to feeding data to the machine learning models. As a corpus, we crawled data from a Reddit community called Debate Communism, which was mostly chosen for the political topic of discussion, which we argue that it implies more complex responses from users. And also the size of the community was medium to large, so we had a lot of conversations to work with. We extracted the last 200 discussion threads. The whole period analyzed consisted of 9 weeks. There were 980 active users out of a total of around 23,000, and a total of around 6,000 comments. The maximum karma or social ranking score was 423, and the minimum was a negative one, minus 247. So now, talking about the various parts of our pipeline. For the data acquisition, we crawled Reddit, as I mentioned, and we did that using a library called Pro, which is a wrapper around the Reddit API, which allows us to extract data in an anonymized fashion. And after that, we inserted the data into an Elasticsearch cluster. For each analyze community, we created a separate index in Elasticsearch. And apart from this, we also generated the regularity analysis, which, as I mentioned before, is only based on the timestamps of comments. So as we crawl data from Reddit, we already had access to those timestamps, so we could compute this step. The next step is the Reader Bench NLP processing pipeline, or CNA pipeline. So we retrieve the discussion threads from Elasticsearch and we fed them into Reader Bench, which built the CNA graph and computed the CNA indices and also computed the textual complexity indices. And I also mentioned interactive visualizations, which are a separate part of Reader Bench. So after finishing the computation of all these indices, there are three main views that are generated, which we'll detail later in the results section. And there is also a heat map generated with all the discussed topics in the community. It is important to mention that all those views are based on the clustering of the members in the community in three categories. These are central users, active users, and peripheric users. So the central ones are the most active in the community, and the peripheral are the ones that do not interact too much. Regarding the user prediction, we used all the categories of indices and fed them into neural networks of the type multilayer perceptron, which allowed us to train then predict the Reddit score and also to evaluate the results. So now moving forward to the results, let's detail a bit about what specific neural networks we used. So we used one single hidden layer with a variable size, the variable size being as detailed here, 4, 8, 16, 32, and 64. And we used each category of indices separately as features, and also we made an experiment with all the features combined. For the evaluation, we used the mean absolute error metric. The best value that we obtained was a value of 15. So this in a sense tells us that the real user rank was predicted with an error of around 15 votes. And as I mentioned previously, we can say that the whole range of values for the Reddit score was about 700. So we concluded that our error precision was relatively good compared to the whole spectrum of available values. And now here we can see plotting of the results. So we have the variation in the hidden layer size and how it generates the mean absolute error. And we can see for different types of features. And we can see that at the end, as we increase the hidden layer size, all of them converge to around the value that I mentioned, so around 15. And now moving on to the visual part, I will shortly present all the views that we generated. So as I mentioned, all of those views are based on the clustering of users in those three categories. So central, active, and peripheral. And this first view creates a graph of them and colors accordingly, and also based on individual cohesion scores, each dot representing each user is bigger or smaller. And also the links between the users are bigger or smaller, also considering the cohesion score of their of the messages they exchanged. The second view is a cluster force layout view, in which all of the users are tried to be grouped together in the same clusters, but avoiding overlaps between them. So it's more or less the same thing as before. And the last type of view is one in which users are presented in a radial manner. So they are stored on a circle and various cohesion links between them are presented here. And the last type of view or visualization is of the topics discussed in the community. So we can see in different weeks, as I mentioned, there were 9 weeks in the analyzed period. We can see for each of the relevant topics, the intensity in which it was discussed in that particular period. Then we can observe some of the topics such as communism, capitalism, economy, or democracy, and they are clearly related to the topic of the community. And now moving on to conclusions and future work. So as I mentioned previously, we predicted the score with an error of about 15 votes from a total range of around 700. All of the indices showed strong connections and relevance to the user rank. And we can conclude that Reddit provides a valuable pool of opportunities for future research in this area. And as future work, we plan to scale the crawling and storage architecture. So, for example, use parallel crawling from Reddit and also add multiple Elasticsearch clusters. We also want to leverage the Reddit search functionality. And mentioned regarding this, at the moment, we can only extract the last in a sequential manner, the last conversations in the community, but this functionality would allow us to extract specific discussion threads related to our search. And as a last step, we would like to integrate the regularity indices into the Reader Bench framework, because at the moment they are computed separately. So that was it. Thank you for listening, and now it's time for questions. And I hope I I didn't exceed by too much the time. I wasn't very much aware.
Thank you. So time for questions.
Maybe I have one.
Yes, please go ahead.
Yes, please.
I would like just to know if you think that this approach sometimes can be applied to have an insight about the relevance of such connection and ranking in the informal learning.
So if I think that, can you repeat the okay. last part, please?
Up to now, you have just checked that you were able to reproduce the Reddit score, let's say
rank, yeah, score. Rank.
So, but of course, this in some sense could be considered a first step for your future work. Do you think that sometimes you can arrive to score the informal learning of the member of the community, the level of informal learning or the relevance for informal learning of the member of the community?
I see, but I'm not quite sure that I understand the term of informal.
The informal learning is the learning that occurs outside of a formal environment, like university, like.
I see. Yes, so I'll try to answer that. So I think, in a sense, this score is a measure of some sort of learning, but it takes it in a much broader sense, because it, as I mentioned at the beginning, Reddit communities can have a wide variety of topics. So there are clearly some of them that are related to learning particular skills or particular ideas, but many of them are strictly related to discussing ideas or sharing some articles or news and discussing that. So I think for the particular learning communities, yes, we can say that there exists a correlation between this score and the degree in which the user has learned. But for the other ones, it is more or less a measure of the popularity of the user in the community and not strictly related to his learning. But we can, I think, give a much broader definition for learning, and if that includes being getting one's ideas as popular in the community and making others users interested in them, maybe in some sense related to how well we learn the interaction with the community. So yeah, I hope I answered your question.
And I also want to shed some light a little bit. So we are doing several experiments. So we've also tried applying the same indices on participation in the Moodle environment, in which we've got a lot of conversation, especially in this period. Or, for example, we're considering blogs with Nix. So we're trying different communities and to see how participation in those communities and how discourse is modeled in those communities can actually be used for several predictions. So in this case, the impact in the community and how well the community perceives a member, or for example, in courses to actually predict the student's score. So in a formal learning environment, it's a lot easier because we can train the model.
Okay, thank you. Are there other questions? I have a quick one.
Yes.
In the beginning, you said that you rate the importance of upvotes as larger than downvotes. That seems to be a random choice.
I see, that's a fair point. It's just, yeah, in a sense, you can say that we could equally went on the other direction, so rated the downvotes much higher, but we thought that upvotes are a greater measure of the appreciation of other users, and we must focus on them. So in a sense, we focused on the positive aspects. But yeah, you can make an argument that we can do some experiments in the opposite direction, so with a greater focus on negative votes. But yeah, that was a good observation.
Okay, thank you. If there are no other questions, then we come to our last presenter. Laurentiu has